Hi everyone, in this video I am going to explain about how to find frequency of AC, that is alternating current, using sonometer and electromagnet. The required apparatus are AC power supply and one step down transformer and a electromagnet coil and sonometer box and these two wedges and sonometer wire, pulley and a weight hanger and different loads and 1 meter scale. Now I explain you how these apparatus will help you to find frequency. Here I took power supply directly from the switchboard, that is 230 volt 50 hertz supply. And it is connected to the primary of this step down transformer to low down the input voltage without affecting the frequency. After decreasing the voltage, output is taken from secondary of this transformer and is connected to the coil electromagnet. Electromagnet consists of iron core, it's wound by copper wire. Whenever current flows through this coil, this iron core behaves like magnet. This electromagnet applies attractive force for every half cycle of applied AC. Because of this force, sonometer wire starts to vibrate. This electromagnet is fixed using this clamp stand. Using this clamp stand, you can adjust this height. Exactly below this electromagnet, sonometer wire is placed. One end of the sonometer wire is connected to this sonometer box and the other end is connected with the help of this pulley to the weight hanger. These two movable wedges helps to fix the resonating length. Let us see how these apparatus will help you to determine the frequency. At first, fill all the given data like mass per unit length of wire, m equals to 19 into 10 raised to minus 4, acceleration due to gravity 9.8 and load. For each trial I am adding 0.5 kg to the weight hanger, so I took 0.5, 1, 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3 kg as my loads. Applied tension is calculated using the formula M into G. For every trial, 9.8 is constant, that is G, and M is taken according to the first column. Now we will see how to find resonating length. For first trial, I have to use 0.5 kg as my load. Here I am not added any load because weight hanger itself has 0.5 kg. Now switch on the power supply. If coil is active, by touching the sonometer wire you can feel vibration. Now begin from zero length. Now move the wedges away such that we have to get a maximum vibration. See here, wire is vibrating in a single loop. Now, length between two sharp edges is called resonating length and it is measured using meter scale. Make sure that wedges should be parallel to each other. Here I have 27.5 as my resonating length for first trial.
Note down the reading 27.5 cm in your observation after converting it into meter, that is 0.275 meter.
For my second trial, load is 1 kg, so I have to add 0.5 kg to the weight hanger. Next, repeat the same procedure as previous. Switch on the power supply. Move the wedges away to get maximum vibration. Now stop the movement of the wedges. Switch off the supply.
Measure the resonating length. Here I have 38.3 cm.
Note down the reading 0.383. Like this, find all the resonating length for these loads. After doing all the 6 trials, you find L square using these numbers. I mean, if you multiply 0.275 by 0.275, you get 0.0756, that is L square.
Using these values, L square and tension, I plot a graph, L square versus tension. I took L square in y axis and tension in x axis. I wrote here 4.9 for 2 centimeters. For 1 centimeter, it is 4.9 divided by 2, that is 2.45.
So I wrote x-axis 1 centimeter equals to 2.45 newton. And also y-axis 1 centimeter equals to 0.05 meter square.
So 1 centimeter equal to 0.05 meter square. So 2 centimeter equals to 0.1. Now take a slope like this. Substitute the AB and BC values in your formula. This AB equals to 5.1, 5.1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. After 5, one line is there. So 5.1. Okay, here BC 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6.9, 9th line, so 6.9 centimeter. After substituting this AB and BC value into Y scale is there. So Y scale value, I have 0.05 and X scale value 2.45. 0.05 in the place of Y scale and 2.45 in the place of X scale. After calculating this, I got 0.015 as my slope.
Now, frequency of AC found using the formula F equals to 1 upon 4 into root of M into slope. Here I have slope as 0.015 and M is mass per unit bend, that is 19 into 10 raised to minus 4. By simplifying this, I got 1 upon 2.1354 into 10 raised to 2. 10 raised to 2 comes from by taking 10 raised to minus 4 outside of the root. So 10 raised to minus 2, moving this 10 raised to minus 2 to numerator, I got 10 raised to plus 2. After simplifying this, I got 46.8 hertz as my frequency.